Hi there, in this video we are going to talk about how you can install Motic on your local server. So Motic is an open source solution in order to do marketing automation. It can allow you to do many different things, but we are just going to talk today about how you can install locally. So why would you like to do that? First of all, because if you like to use Motic in their cloud, of course you have to pay, so it's even better to install it on your own server. But as a server costs money, probably you want to test it first. And the good news is that you can test it on your local server, and that's what we're gonna do today. So in order to test it on your local server, you need to have a local server so you can install Apache. You need to have as well a database server. So I strongly recommend you to go for a MySQL server, and once you have this, then you can start running the installation process. Out of the error that you can do is the following one. You can directly go on GitHub and download the Motic software. This is exactly what you shouldn't do. Why? Because if you do so, you will see that the version that you download here does not work on your computer. Okay, so the installation that you need to have, the file that you need to get, is the one that you get directly on the Motic website. So let me check. Yeah, that's the one. Okay, you need to go on this given page and /download motic.org/download, and then you need to download this. So of course you need to give away your email address. You can put a fake email address here and you will get your download file. So it's I can do it right now. So I'm gonna do it like this. I'm gonna do it like this, like this. Toot, and yeah, it's toot at toot.com, and choose your country, Afghanistan, and choose your role, marketing executive. Okay, so you click over here on download, and you will see that it will download the file. So I can click again, and it's taking a bit of time before starting to download it, but you will see that you will get, at the end of the day, you will get this. You will get the .point15.3.zip file that you save. Once you save it, you need to move it to your local server. So this is what happened here. So I'm just gonna clean this up. So here I'm on my local server, and what I need to do is that I need to transfer the file that I just get within this given folder that I'm gonna create now. So sudo mkdir motic. Okay, and now I have a folder which is named motic. Okay, so nothing within it, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move the file that I was just showing you some seconds ago. So it's over here, over here, and 2.15. okay, that's the one that I need to move here. So here I just need to move back, and yeah, I need to do so, and Motic. Okay, all good. So now what do I have? CD Motic. Oops. Okay, so now I have my zip file. So as you can see, it's exactly like WordPress. You go, you download something, you get a zip file, you go on your local server, you create a directory, and then within your directory you unzip the file. Okay, so nothing crazy here. 2.15, and that's it. Okay, so at this given step, what do you have? So you have many files within your Motic folder file, and if you go on localhost, localhost/motic, what you will get is this given error message telling you that there is something wrong. And what they are trying to tell you here is that you need to give the right to Motic to modify the files that you just imported. And for this, you just need to look through the documentation of Motic, and here they're going to give you the magic line. So you need to change the owner rights, and you need to give the possibility to Motic to be able to edit the file. So this is what we're going to do. So we're going to just copy and paste this given line. I'm going to say that we want it to work on the Motic folder and all the other files included within this folder. And this is what we just did here. So next, you come back over here and you refresh. And if you refresh, you will see that it's probably not working. It's going to ask you to clear the cache as well. So I'm just going to okay, so like this, and you clear your cache, so CTRL F5. And then you have Motic, which start to be installed. So here you click on next step, and here it's telling you, okay, right now configure the database. So this is where you need to have already a local server which is running a database, which is my case. So I just go for sudo MySQL. Okay, so now I'm within my MySQL server, and I need to create a database. So in my case, I'm gonna create one, which will be so I wish I could have the sequence. Sorry for that. Just gonna go like this. Okay, and I'm gonna just like, because I don't know, create database. Because I don't know the MySQL sequence by heart. So I'm gonna go over here and I'm just gonna create a database. Okay, so what you need is that you need to create a database. So you go over here and you create a database to which you will give a name. So in my case, it will be Motic. I'm gonna call it Motic one. Okay, and now you have a database which is created. Okay, next step is about giving privileges to the identifier that you want of your database. So in my case, what I'm gonna do is something like this. So I want to give the right Motic one. Okay, to the database Motic one, and I want to give the rights to the user that I have within my database, which is myself. Okay, all good. So now I have a Motic database, which is named Motic one, and I gave the rights to the given user of my database to be able to play with it. So if I go on my phpMyAdmin, as you can see, I have something which is called, I should have something which is named Motic one here. So I'm just gonna go back over here, grant all privileges. Okay, on create a database which is named Motic one. Okay, Motic one, it's created, and then give all the privileges to this one. So okay, now I have a database which is Motic one, and there's nothing in this database, and the reason is that, of course, no table have been created left because I did not launch this given script which is behind this form. So database name is Motic one, database table prefix, I don't care about this one, database username, so it's gonna be Ronan, which is myself, and the database password is the one that you inserted when you install your MySQL server database. Backup existing table, no, because I don't have any. And then it's, in fact, as I said, creating the different tables. So if you are a little bit curious and that you go back over here, you will see that a lot of tables have been created, and that's the magic of scripts. Okay, and now, so I'm gonna give a username. So I'm gonna be very original here. I'm gonna give a username, which is this one. I'm gonna give a password, which is this one. As it's in local, I don't care. And here I can give the name that I want. Okay, email address, I don't mind neither, but I'm gonna just put the one of the Floss Marketing School because I think it's funnier this way. Okay, next step. So okay, blah blah blah, and this one is fine as well, so I can go for next step, and I'm here. So now I just need to say, hey, this is my name, keep me logged in if I want, and welcome to Motic. So now Motic is installed, that's great. So you can already start to play a little bit with here. So you can already start, for example, to enter some contacts and see how it looks like. So hey Mr. DJ, okay, and you can, like this, in fact, start to already play with Motic, see how it looks like, and as you can see, you get your first contacts which are recorded, and then you can start to design your own landing pages. You can click over here and you can say, hey, I wish I could have a great landing page which will look like this one, and you can say, hey, great landing page, you can save and close, and then you can already start to see how the page look like. And you can already start. So to design your own landing pages, you can already probably start to send you your own email, start to deploy your own script, and so on and so forth. So you have a full Motic that you can play with it endlessly in order to start to train yourself about Moting. So of course, it's not like a production version. It's everything hosted locally, but at least you can now discover marketing automation without spending a penny. And that's it for today. So we hope that you enjoyed this video and that you will be able to deploy Motic as well on your local server. Thanks for watching.